Game Pickups Live, coming at you live right about now. Showing. What was that? That was an intro. Yes. Welcome to Game Pickups Live, where this is Game Pickups number 77 or 78. I don't know. I did find a Game Pickups video I haven't aired yet, so that's going to be an interesting one. Yes, I recorded it around the 5th, 6th, and 7th of January? Yeah. And I've looked all over my channel and I cannot find it anywhere. So I'm assuming I never uploaded it. Oh dear. So that's going to be coming out soon. I don't know whether it's going to come out before or after this, but this is Game Pickups Live, number 77 or 78, one of the two. So yes, we have a bunch of games, not many, but we have an absolute ton of accessories and other stuff, so let's dive straight into those. So as you guys may know, not too long ago, quite recently, we've been getting more into car boot sales and stuff like that. So I figured I would get all these bits out of the way, because I'm not sure if I've already shown you in a prior Game Pickups video, because, well, all the Game Pickups videos are all up in the air. So, yeah, and it doesn't help that I also shared them with friends, let them know what I bought, so now in my head I think I've shown it on a video. God damn it. So, first up, let me just go ahead and just get it straight out of the ballpark and be like, I picked up a gaming wheel. Another one. I know! I have about 20 now. I have like 20. It's ridiculous. But if you guys... I found this during the car boot sale. And the reason why I picked this one up is because I saw this. I was like, this looks awfully familiar. Now, you might remember, a year or two back during one of my Game Pickups videos, I found this, and I got it for free. Just a little gear stick thing. I know, it makes me go ree as well. The moment I saw it, I actually went ree. I was like, ree, I've said that before. And I saw the wheel it was connected to. So I finally found this. So now I've got two of these, even though I can cannibalize the other one for a gear as the actual... Ooh. That's not good. I think I'll replace it with the other one. But yeah. Found this, and I was like, okay, what else is it attached to? It's attached to this wheel, and it is a really fucking awesome wheel. Let me just grab it all up. It comes with, you know, good old pedals, but what's more important is what it works with. Let me just drag it all up. Which console's it for? I don't know. Because... it's got an Xbox connector, a GameCube connector, a PlayStation connector, and what I can only assume is either PC or 360 connector. I don't know. The box did come with it, but the box was absolutely trash, so we just threw it in the bin, and I forgot to read it. So I'll have to look up on the internet what it is. It's adjustable, which is really nice. And it also comes with it came with a bunch of other things. Like this, I suppose this is to secure it to a desk or something? I have no idea, but it all came together. I got it for literally a fiver. You cannot go wrong with this. It's got buttons all over the place. Really, really weird buttons. I don't know what the heck to make of this. I really don't. But hey, I picked up another wheel, and it's a wheel that goes with all consoles. That's why I bought it. For some reason, it also came with this. What is it? It is a iPod dock. iPod iPhone dock. Funny thing is, it's got AUX in. So I can just use it as a regular speaker and plug an MP3 player to it. So that's pretty darn cool. It's got batteries in it, but I'm damned if I know if it works or not. They haven't got any LED indicators. So, don't know, we'll have to find out about that one. And it also came with a freaking iToy. So I've got another iToy camera. I'd show you, but I can't bother pulling it out because it's a massive mess of cables. Oh, and it also comes with another thing, maybe to help secure it, I don't know. It just all came in one big bag, so don't know what to expect from that. Now this, I found on someone's stall during the car boot. Now this brings back so many memories because I used to play around with one of these. But I can't remember how the freaking hell you play with it anymore. Scanners. Scanners Commander. Do you guys remember the shit being advertised on TV? You basically walk in a shop and you start scanning items. And you get to battle, like, monsters and stuff. Because of what's in it. It's really, really weird. I don't know if it'll work today. I really don't. But it comes with a whole bunch of freaking cards. And also the instruction manual. So I might have a little fiddle around with that just for fucking shits and giggles. Because, God, I have not touched one of these in... It's over a decade now. It doesn't really say the year on it, I don't think. Oh, yeah, it does. 2001. That's over 16 years ago. 16 freaking years ago. So, yeah. Remember, get your scanners now! Go scan things! Battle monsters! So, yeah. Pick that up for a few quid. So bad. I know, Bolt. I know. So I had to pick it up. I don't even know if it works, but I don't care. For a few quid, I'm willing to try. And these were 50p each. I know they're not games game-related, but technically there's video games based on the characters. I got Batman v Superman for 50p on Blu-ray. Say what you want about the film, but 50p, it's the ultimate edition as well. I don't know what's so good about... You know, 2 hours of extras? Yay. I don't get it. But either way... I got Batman v Superman on Blu-ray for 50p. Cannot go wrong with that. And I also got Thor. Good old Thor. I don't have any physical versions of these movies because I'm a filthy pirate, but, you know. Well, thing is, I pirated it once for the girlfriend to watch because she hadn't seen it. And the last time I saw it was in the cinema. Does that count? Yeah, it probably counts as piracy. But whatever, I don't care. I deleted it anyway because I don't see the point in keeping movies. So, yeah, that's pretty freaking awesome. So, what else did we get? Okay. So, I was exploring the car boot sale, as I was, and I rummaged through some woman's box of toys that she took from her kid's room. It had this in it. This thing here. And I'm like, I know that. That's from Mario. And I looked around the box and I couldn't find the figure with it. It was just that. Now, if you remember, a little while ago, quite a while ago, probably over a year ago now, I got this. And I was like, it didn't come with the other part for it. Well, lo and behold... for like, I think she gave it to me for 10p. Because it didn't come with the figure. Well, I had the figure and not the stand. Now I've got both. So now they can finally become one, which makes me so happy. And what makes me even more happy is that it actually makes a sound. Toys for children. This is so good. It makes me so happy. So I'm so happy and so made up to have actually made this complete once more. I know it's a bloody Happy Meal toy from 2014. But, hey, it's finally won. I'm going to make it worse. And am I going to abuse the GOG sale to expand my backlog?
I already have.
If only I could show you guys my digital purchases as well for my game pickups, but I don't think that really counts as a pickup. Okay, so... last game pickups video that's actually been published. Actually, no, I don't think it's been published yet. I'm so behind. Now, you may know that I picked up this. I got this in a Funko Pop mystery box. Mr. Handy. This made me very happy because all I ever wanted was the robots. Because I don't like the figures. So I got Mr. Handy. And then recently I purchased this. The Assaultron, which made me very happy. And then I alluded to maybe the girlfriend bought me a gift from America. And we had to wait for it to arrive from America. I now have the full robot collection. You guys can't see it, but it's coming. Boom! Oh, yes. We got the actual Protectron from the Funko Pop mystery boxes. Had to order it from America because for some reason no one's selling them on eBay. You'd think someone would buy a shit ton of those mystery boxes, open them all, and sell them on eBay, but whatever. Yeah. The Assaultron.
Assaultron.
The Protectron, because I just looked at the Assaultron. So now I have the full robotic set, and it makes me so freaking happy to have the whole set straight from America to my home with the rest of my Fallout collection. Makes me so happy, so happy to finally have it. I need it. I needed it so bad. I was contemplating getting the rest of the figures, but that seemed like a complete waste of time. So I opted not to. Alright, so the next thing I got was this. This little GameWare thing. I saw it and I was like, please be a DS case. Because you guys know I'm looking for DS cases that can, you know, that can hold DS games. And lo and behold, I opened it up and I was like, holy shit, how much do you want for it? 50p. I was like, fuck yeah, 50p. Checked it out. I was like, this is mine. So now I finally have a proper and a really good DS game holder. Whereas the other one I got isn't as good. And I'm not sure what I did with it. I have no idea where it is. It is lost. So yeah, it's a lot better than the one I've already got. The cheap plastic ones from China just break. That little plastic one I got for a few quid, wherever I've put it, it feels flimsy. So this is a nice solid one. You can pull it, rag on it. Not that I will, but I'm just saying this is solid. Velcro, no games again out of there. Very good, 50p. I can finally keep my DS game safe. Speaking of a DS... look what I got for a fiver. I found it and I was like, how much do you want from it? Does it work? And she was like, yep, we charged it up last night. Now, there's nothing better than going to a car boot sale and the sellers have charged up the devices and you all got videos of their electronics actually working before actually showing us. So this thing's a little bit damaged, but it is a fully functioning DS console. Doo-doo! And it has a game already in it, which is awesome. So for a fiver, I got myself a DS, which is very nice. Doesn't come with the stylus, but not the end of the world. They're fucking everywhere. I've got like 50 of them. And it came with Harry Potter. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 1. By the looks of it, it's either Part 1 or Part 2. I couldn't tell you. I'm assuming Part 1. But yeah, came with Harry Potter as well. So now I've got a spare DS Lite, so now we've got 3 DS Lites, which is awesome. I know it's pink, but at the end of the day, I'm not going to go outside with it because I don't take my consoles out, really. So that's not the end of the world. I'm going to take this awesome game that we got, Harry Potter, Part 1, Deathly Hallows. I'm going to put it in my nice new game case, which is awesome. So, that's most of the accessories out the way. I did get this as well. This is a little CD case. But it's full of games. It is so full of games. So that is pretty freaking awesome. So I'm going to be showing you that right about now. I'm just going to get these couple out of the way now. I picked up some car-only games from Granger Games. Because you guys know what I'm like for my DS games now. I'm trying to collect as many as I can. Whether they're cart-only or in a case, it doesn't matter to me. But I like getting a really good deal. And for a quid each... I was going to get these. Granger Games are selling all of their cart-only games at really discounted prices. It's totally worth getting. The first one is Prince of Persia Battles. I don't know if that's a very good game. It probably isn't. It's probably a pile of crap. I don't even know if there's any autofocus. But Prince of Persia Battles, and the other one is Dragon Ball Origins. Now that one, I looked on CX, and that was worth quite a bit, and they were selling it for a quid. So, I know it's a cart only, but still, I find that quite ridiculous that a game is cost so much, and yet they'd sell just a cart only for like a quid. Can't go wrong with that. So, Dragon Ball Origins, pretty awesome stuff there. That's going to go in my DS case there. So, what else do we have? Well, let's go to the different view and show you guys. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Hold on. I've been working on this all day. Whee! Oh, you don't even see. Whee! There you go, now you do. So, as you can see, I now have a webcam above me. Here it is. But Dan, that looks like a Logitech C920. Yes, it's a Logitech C920, but I'm also using a Logitech C920 right there. But Dan, you've only got one. Nope. As of today, the awesome person that is Max B. You guys know Max B. You've seen him in the chat. He is absolutely awesome. He is a legend and he's a very, very good friend. He sent me his webcam because he doesn't need it anymore. He doesn't, you know, he got a replacement. He's using an actual camera now. I think he's using a Nikon camera, which is absolutely awesome. I'm kind of tempted to try out what he's doing with his. So he sent me his C920. So now I've got two of them. What the hell am I going to do with all these webcams? So awesome. He also sent a two-way HDMI splitter, a proper one. This one's by Cynic. You know, he sent me that. It comes with the cable as well. Comes with its own little power cable, which is very nice. I don't like the plug ones. The USB ones tend to not burn out because it's USB. So that's pretty awesome. So yeah, he sent me a proper HDMI splitter. It's metal, which is nice. And he also sent these freaking light-up corks, which is also awesome. So I'm going to be putting those in my bottles and hopefully making some nice, awesome effects with these. So big thanks to the Max B for that. So we're in our nice new webcam view. Let me show you what I picked up. Now, a while ago, I picked up the worst gaming handheld gaming console ever released. It's the worst gaming handheld console in the universe. I'm talking about the one and only Gamecom. The worst handheld console ever released. It comes with Batman and Robin and Lights Out, which is, meh. But I picked up something that might redeem it. Here it is. The Gamecom Williams Arcade Classics. Absolutely awesome. It comes with five games on it. Joust, Defender, Robotron, Defender 2, Stargate, and Sinistar. Run, coward. Beware, I live. I'm expecting it to be horribly crap because those screenshots make it look really crap. But, yeah, I picked up another Gamecom game sealed in its original packaging, so I'm going to be really, really torn about opening it, but then I realize it's the Gamecom, so I don't really care. So I'm gonna open this up, and when I do my review of the Gamecom, which is coming one day, I'm trying to pick up a couple more games for it, I now have Williams Arcade Classics for it. That's going to be an interesting one, isn't it? Okay, so before we actually go down to the physical releases of games, I want to get this sleeve out of the way. This sleeve, I found at the car boot. It is jam-packed full of discs. They sold it to me for £2. For £2. I thought it was just a CD case, but when I picked it up, I went, fucking hell, that's heavy. What the hell's in it? Opened it up, it's full of games and stuff. And they just wired £2 for it. So, it doesn't matter what games are in here. For £2, I just got a steal of a deal. So let's see what's inside. Oh no, there's nothing. Oh no, there's nothing. Oh no, there's nothing. I think I've opened it backwards. Whoop! There we go, let's try that. Alright, so, in this one, we have the bonus disc of Mr. Bean, animated. Which is not a gaming related thing, but there are a ton of games in here. So, that's cool. Got Mr. Bean animated. I've got The Fault in Our Stars now. I've got that on DVD. Okay, that's pretty cool. I actually like that movie. Warm Bodies, the movie. That movie's a bit shit, but it's zombies. I love zombies, can't go wrong. Warm Bodies is a bit crap, though. But here we go. This is where we come up to the, video games. I have Rage. Unfortunately, it's Disc 1. I don't know if it comes with Disc 2. Doesn't look like it. But I have Disc 1 of Rage, which is nice. I have the PS3 version of Alpha Protocol. Now, I've already got that. It's up there. Not a big deal. But Alpha Protocol on PS3, absolutely fantastic RPG. You cannot go wrong with it. It's a very, very fun RPG to play on your console, so go for it. Far Cry 3 for PlayStation 3 as well. Excellent game. Can't go wrong with it. I don't think I've actually got it. No, I've got Far Cry 2. I do not have Far Cry 3 on PlayStation 3, so that's awesome. The Bourne Conspiracy for PlayStation 3. I'm fairly certain I've got that. Fairly certain. Yes, I do. Not a big deal. But again, awesome game. DJ Jam, Def Jam Icon. Never played it. Don't know what to expect from that. But hey, that's pretty cool. Got that for PlayStation 3. Assassin's Creed 3 for PlayStation 3. Now, I'm fairly certain I've got it because I've got all of them. Yep, I've got all of them. So that's not a big deal. So I got Assassin's Creed 3 for PlayStation 3. Holy shit, that's awesome. I got Hellboy, which is different. Hellboy and the Golden Army That is actually really... I love the Hellboy films. I really do wish they'd bring out another one. So getting another Hellboy film on DVD, really good. Now, here's an awesome PS3 game right here. Spec Ops The Line. Absolutely phenomenal game. Obviously best played on PC, which is the place where I originally played it. But yeah, getting it on PS3, really awesome. Very good shooter. I definitely recommend it. Lost the Video Game. Red Dead Redemption, now that's a good one, for PlayStation 3, cannot go wrong with that, so getting that for PlayStation 3 is an absolute steal, even though I've already got it, but hey, getting a spare copy, you cannot go wrong. For some reason there's two discs in here. Whoop. So what have we got? We have Killzone 2, which is a pretty good game. I really do enjoy the Killzone series, went a little bit weird towards the end, but still a solid shooter for the PlayStation 3. Terminator Salvation. Probably not the greatest Terminator film, but definitely not the worst. So, you know, you can't go wrong with that. You know, it introduced some new Terminators and an interesting plot point, which was very nice. It was a good talking point. Call of Duty Black Ops on PlayStation 3. Again, can't go wrong. Mass Effect 3 for PlayStation 3. I don't even know if I've got that. I probably do, because you guys know what I'm like. I've got every freaking game. Yep, I've got it, but you can't go wrong. Mercenaries 2, World in Flames, phenomenal PlayStation 3 title, so you can't go wrong with that. Resistance 2, again, fantastic game. You can't go wrong with these games, all these sequels are really, really good. Resistance 2 had absolutely phenomenal co-op. I really, really am sad that they shut it down. I wish they didn't, but what can you do about it? There's nothing I can do about it. What is this? This is Game and Pickup, Cyber Cheater. You should know that. It says in the title, bro. PES 2009. Meh. That's all I have to say about that. Meh. It's not a very good game. But then again, it's better than FIFA, apparently. So, whatever. Next up, we have Fracture. Now, Fracture's a pretty sweet game. Glad I got that. Now, here's the one that really made me buy it. Because I was on the fence about buying... this sleeve, even though it was only £2, but the moment I saw this, I had to get it. Hitman HD Trilogy on PlayStation 3. I have been pining for this for so freaking long, and now I finally have it. It also comes with, behind it, Uncharted 3 Drake's Deception, which is pretty awesome, but this is awesome on its own. Hitman HD Trilogy, absolutely fantastic. Now I can play freaking Hitman Blood Money on the PlayStation 3. Oh yes, Batman, I need that. Next up, we have another PlayStation 3 title, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. Pretty cool. I don't have it. I'll go for it. Why not? X-Men Origins, Wolverine. The game's okay. Whatever. It's the Uncaged Edition, whatever that means. What else we got? We have UFC Undisputed 2009 for 360. Sure, whatever. Not a big fan of these fighting games, but whatever, I'll take it. Overlord 2, now that's a game I can definitely get behind. Absolutely phenomenal game, and now I've got Overlord 2 on PlayStation 3. No, I think I've probably already got it. Let's have a look. No, I just have Overlord Raising Hell. So, big win there. I now have Overlord 2. So, yes, so many new titles for my game list, which is awesome. So, I got PES 2008. So, what was that? PES 2009 or something like that? I can't remember. Wherever it is. Yeah, PES 2008. Whatever, if you like football games. Unreal Tournament for PlayStation 3. Hell yes, and that's all she wrote. So for £2, I got all of these freaking games. All of these games for £2. What the hell? What the hell? You cannot go wrong with that. And having them all in a sleeve like this just makes it more handy. Absolute shame that they threw away all the boxes and manuals and stuff. I hate when people do that. But hey, I got the Spores of War from here. I got myself a sleeve full of epic games for £2. Oh my god, the hype. So, we may as well stay in this view for the last few games of the gear gaming pickups. So the first one is a game for the girlfriend, it was £1. So I figured I'd pick it up for 99 pennies, wasn't even £1. Zoo Tycoon DS. She likes her animal games, especially for the DS, so I figured I'd get this one for her. You know, it was only 99p, you know, why the hell not? It's a free gift for the girlfriend. The case is a little bit smashed, but not the end of the world. Comes complete with the manual, Zoo Tycoon DS. Can't go wrong with it. Fun little game for the DS. Next up, we have... I picked this one up, Pac-Pix. Now, you guys know I love my Pac-Man. And for a pound... Yes, they were selling this for a pound. So I figured it was an awful game. But it comes complete with manual and game. Not sure what it is. Apparently you're meant to draw, which is awesome. Use the stylus to draw Pac-Man into life, control his movements, use this innovative title that takes advantage of the touchscreen like no other game. Draw Pac-Man and watch as he comes to life and eat the ghosts. Draw arrows and bombs to hit ghosts and activate switches. Really weird one. Not too sure about that. Guess we'll have to check it out. But it sounds awful, looks awful, but for a pound, I'm willing to give it a go because I love Pac-Man. Can't go wrong with it. So, boom. Pick that up. Next up, this game, the girlfriend got me from a charity shop. It was a pound. Can't go wrong. I'm so proud of the girlfriend. She's been getting more and more into it. Basically, I've been avoiding this game for PlayStation 3 because I know how bad Fallout 3 ran on PS3. It's a very, very depressing experience. The further you get into the game, the more the system will crash and crash and crash. And it doesn't just crash, it hard crashes. You require a hard reset every time it crashes. It's not good. Bethesda should be royally ashamed of themselves for the state that their games came out on PlayStation 3. Now, I have a feeling the Fallout New Vegas, because of how similar it is to Fallout 3, it literally is Fallout 3, but with... It's like a standalone DLC for Fallout 3, but a very, very good one. Fallout New Vegas is an absolutely phenomenal game. Absolutely adore it, but if you have to get it for PC. The girlfriend knew I didn't have it, though, and for a pound, I'm so proud that she bought it for me. She bought it for our collection. So getting Fallout New Vegas on PlayStation 3 cannot go wrong. I finally have it in my collection, and it's going to look good up there next to Fallout 4 and Fallout 3. Now, Fallout 4 is only up there because it doesn't... Yeah, I know it's for PC, but it doesn't look right. Because it's in a Blu-ray case, of all things. So I opted to put it with the PS3 games, because they're all in Blu-ray cases. Alright, so the next one I picked up is The Cursed Crusade. Now, this one is a little bit different. I've not seen this game before. It was only a couple of quid, so I figured I'd at least give it a go. I'm not sure if it's any good, though. Those who live by the sword shall die by the sword. I absolutely love Crusade games because they've always been fun. The part of the reason that made me love the Crusade, fighting in the Crusade games, is possibly because of Assassin's Creed. Assassin's Creed really hit home with the Crusades. It really did well with the Templars and all that. It was really, really good. I really enjoyed that, the way they showed the atmosphere in the battlefields. It was really fun. It was really groundbreaking for their first game. So, you know, that's why the Crusades will always have a special place in my heart in gaming history. So, I'm not too sure what to expect from this one. You're going to be a young Templar of a dishonored family driven by an iron will and a desire for revenge. Your soul is afflicted by the Templar's curse, which grants mighty strength in battle, but will ultimately damn you to hell. Okay. But I get to kill people, so that's all that matters, right? So The Cursed Crusade, pretty awesome. Comes complete with the manual and the disc. I figured I'd give it a go, because I've never heard of it before until I found it. This was a quid, of course. You know, you guys know, I like the PlayStation Move, but then again, I like the Wii, so that's probably why I like the PlayStation Move. I really do like my motion games, only if they're done right. There are so many really bad ones, and this is probably one of them, but I'm willing to try all of them. So the PlayStation Move Carnival Island for PlayStation 3. It's some children's game. It's got a shit ton of stuff in it. It's got Havoc in it, Physics by NVIDIA, and of course it uses Bing Video for its video. But that's really interesting. It's 1-4 players, so I don't know. I'll give it a go. Why not? Comes complete with the manual and disc. Can't go wrong with that. Very nice. Next up, I got this at the car boot. And the part of the reason... Now, part of the reason I picked up those DVDs wherever I threw them... Now, where did I throw them? I don't know where I threw them. Oh, threw them right here. Now, the reason why I picked up these DVDs and Blu-rays is because this was with it. And he said everything in the box was 50p. So I was like, okay, I'll pick those up. And then I picked this up because it was in the box. I got Star Wars Battlefront for PlayStation 4 for 50p. Now, you guys know I'm currently, you know, trying to get some funds raised for a PlayStation 4. This will be played with it. Of course it will. Star Wars Battlefront, And it comes with a code that's probably been used, but hey, awesome. Yep, Star Wars Battlefront, the Battle of Jakku, early access code inside, which is awesome. That's probably already in the game now. But yes, Star Wars Battlefront for PlayStation 4 for 50 frickin' P. Say what you want about the game. I will shit on it forever, but I will not shit on its graphics. The graphics are fucking gorgeous. This game is so beautiful. It is so good looking. And it runs quite well. But hey, for 50p, I'm not going wrong. You cannot pick this game up for 50p anyway. You can't even find it for a pound, let alone 50p. But yeah, the guy did know the real value of that trash game. Yeah, it is not Battlefront. I will stand up and be like, that game is not Battlefront. It can get fucked. I hope that they make Battlefront 2 better. But it pisses me off that there's going to be two Battlefronts 2. Ugh, hurts my brain. But yeah, can't go wrong with that. Whatever, I'll grab it. Alright, so next up, I've got Animal Crossing for the Wii. Let's go to the city. Now, I found this for a pound in a charity shop. Can't go wrong with that. Comes complete with the manual and disc. Now, I never had a single Animal Crossing game on the Wii until now. What's awesome is that it uses some kind of adapter thing. I don't know what that is. What is that? Is that for Amiibos or what? No, because I don't think Amiibos came on the Wii, did they? I don't know. Apparently it works with the DS. I don't know. I guess if you've got the game on DS, I don't know. But yeah, Animal Crossing Let's Go to the City for the Wii. I know nothing about it, but hey, for a quid, I was going to grab it. Can't go wrong. The girlfriend got me this. Now, what's awesome about it is she knew I already had it. But, you know, for £1, I'm going to get another copy of this game because it's absolutely phenomenal. It is my favourite Fallout game of all time. It really is. Well, Fallout 2 is my favourite Fallout game. But the one I most enjoyed playing was Fallout 3, even over Fallout 4. And that's probably because of mods, though. If I had to go for a vanilla game, I'd obviously choose 4 because that's the most playable. But Fallout 3, I love the atmosphere. I love the environments. I love the gameplay of it. The shooting's a bit shit, but VATS makes it easier. It's a very, very good game. Fallout 3, promotional copy, not for resale. Got it. Why not? Big thanks to the girlfriend for getting me that. She's currently at work. That's why you're not hearing her in the background. All right. So, some poor schmuck bought this for £15 from CEX. Dark Souls. I got this from the car boot sale for a frickin' pound. Dark Souls on 360. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And I'm not sure if it's got backwards compatibility yet on the Xbox One, but I definitely look forward to doing that whenever I get an Xbox One, because, you know, pretty awesome beans. So, yeah, Dark Souls for Xbox 360. I already have it, but for a pound, I'm going to get another copy. Why the hell wouldn't you? So, yeah, can't go wrong with that. Dark Souls on 360. Boom. Yay for car boot sales. Next up, got this for the girlfriend. You know, we're trying to get more into the Kinect, so I'll get both of these out, why not? Got these, Rabbids Alive and Kicking, and Kinectimals, now with bears. It's probably really shit. I mean, it's the Kinect. It's shit. But I suppose we might have a fun experience, who knows. For a pound, we were going to grab them. They were a pound each, so why the hell not? Over 1 million units sold. Yeah, I'm sure they all enjoyed it. So yeah, I'm definitely going to have a play around with the Kinect at some point, and when I do, these games will be played with it. So I'm looking forward to doing that and finding out just how bad it really is. This one is from the girlfriend once more. Again, so proud of her. Because she's working so far away during her lunch hour, she actually goes to town, has a look around the charity shops, and comes home with any games she can find. So proud. Like, when the hell's she ever done that? She doesn't do it. But, yep, she did it for me. She sent me a text one day asking if I had Need for Speed Undercover. I checked. I checked the list. Nope. Checked over there. Nope. I do not have Need for Speed Undercover. And she texts back, "Phew, because I've just got it, you." And I was like, holy shit! So, boom. It comes complete with the manual. So proud of the girlfriend. She picked it up for me for a pound from a charity shop. Can't go wrong with that. Apparently, this is one of the greatest Need for Speed games ever made after Underground. So I'm really looking forward to playing it because I see Kayser playing Undercover all the freaking time. I don't know if it's Undercover or Undercover 2. I don't know. I stopped paying attention to the series after Underground. So yeah, can't go wrong with that. Trust no one. No one. Outrun everyone. Is Zoo Tycoon on the backlog? Yeah, of course. The PC version? No, I've played that. But the DS version? No, I've never played that at all. Now, Bioshock Tin Edition. Basically... Sorry, I had a bit of... I had a pack of crisps before I started. I'm still digging them out of my teeth. But, yeah. Went to the car boot. And, yeah. Steelbook edition of Bioshock. I can feel the bumps. So good. You guys know what I'm like for my steelbooks. If I can find a steelbook dirt cheap, I'm gonna get it. I don't give a damn. So, as you can see, I just got the steelbook edition of Bioshock. What's great about it was the price. I asked how much they wanted for it, and the lady said, I don't know, because the lady who's selling it, her daughter, had wandered off to have a look around the car boot, and I was like, okay, I will come back later. We came back later when the lady came back, and she was like, pound. Boom! Got it for a pound. Can't go wrong. Picking it up. You know what I'm like for my steelbooks. I'm going to pick up every single one if I can. Every single one. I don't give a damn. If I can find them cheap, I'm grabbing them. So for a pound, I grabbed that. The car boot sale, found inside of a box full of DVDs, Diblob 2. This was also a pound. Cannot go wrong with that. It's from the same place that sold me the DVDs and the PS4 game. The Revolution will be colorized, 3D compatible. Explore, paint your way past icy outposts. Whatever. Didn't know what to expect from it. Comes complete with the manual, of course, and for a quid, I was willing to get it. Why not? I don't have it, so now I do. Next up, found this in a charity shop for a pound. SpongeBob SquarePants Lights, Camera, Pants. I imagine it's very similar to the Animaniacs one. There is an Animaniacs game, Lights, Camera, Action. I'm going to imagine this is very similar to that, but SpongeBob themed. I don't know what to expect, but if you like SpongeBob, whatever, go nuts. I figured I'd get it, why the hell not? Comes with, complete with the manual and disc, so can't go wrong with that. Do you want to know a little story about this, though? So we went in the charity shop, I looked for games, found this. I also found Uprising 2 on PC. Uprising 2. I've been craving for that game since I was a child. I had it once, and I don't know what happened to the freaking copy of it, but I definitely don't have it now, and I've been craving to get it back since. I'm going to assume a friend stole it, back when they stayed over. Yeah, shitty friends. Can't go wrong with that, though, but when you're a child, shit like that's going to happen. So, Uprising 2 was there. I was going to buy it. I picked it up excitedly, opened up the case. Inside was a copy of fucking PES. I was so pissed. I looked in every case. Looking for it. I was like looking for a PES game, hoping that, you know, so they'd swap the disc. Nope. Someone. Oh. Uprising 2. I was this close to owning it again. So depressed. But yeah. So I ended up getting that with a sorry, sad, broken heart. But. Hey. In the charity shop next door, I found this. Warcraft. Orcs and Humans. Sold Out. Published by Sold Out. It's the original Warcraft game. Boom. Works on Windows 95, 98, and Millennium. I'm sure I can get it working on one of my older systems. I'd be more than happy to play this. You cannot go wrong with that. The original Warcraft game. The game that spawned all the entertainment and fun. It's right here in my hands. I now own it. Makes me happy. Now here's a piece of shit. I'm going to quickly pass this one. Kokoto Kart Racer. It's a generic kart racing game similar to, you know, Sonic Racing Transformed and, you know, Mario Kart. It's got weapons, speeds, hidden races, two-player games. It's got weapons, all that other crap. It's basically a generic game for the PC. It's just a kart racer. That's all it is. It doesn't have a manual. That's how shit it is. It's the type of game you'd find in Poundland, and I paid a pound for it, so either way, whatever. Got myself a shitty kart racer. Next up, Spyro, A Hero's Tale. Now, I've already got it, of course, but, you know, for 99 pennies, I was going to pick up another copy of a Spyro game, because I absolutely adore Spyro. Spyro is a game you should all definitely get. Of course, nothing beats the original Spyro game on PS1, but hey, I'm going to pick up all the games I can whenever I can. Same goes if I find Crash Bandicoot, I'm going to pick that up. I'm going to pick that shit up. I'm going to buy it every time because they're getting so hard to find now. They're so expensive now. So getting a nice spare copy to keep nice and safe in my collection makes me very happy. So having a spare copy of Sparrow Hero's Tale. Now, apparently I didn't own this bullshit. Ace Lightning. Originally, someone bought it from GameStation for 49 pence. Of course, the place I bought it from tried selling it for a pound. They looked right at the front of it, did that with it, looked at it and went, pound please. And I was like, look mate, some motherfucker bought that for 49p and you're going to charge me a pound. And he was like, fine. I was like, I'll give you 50p. I'm like, I'm not giving you more than 50p for that. And he was like, nah, fine. So maybe I'm a piece of shit for haggling down 50 pennies, but whatever. I'm not paying a pound for something that says 49p from it from years ago. Hell no. Hell no. If you're going to keep, if you're going to be lazy enough to keep the price on, at least charge lower than the price, you know? So I paid him 50p. Why not? You never seen a silver PS2 case? Really? All of the Platinum games, basically Platinum games are like second editions. They're re-releases. Every Platinum game in the UK, at least, comes in a silver case. They're all silver. Whereas, you know, this is the regular edition. The re-releases usually have a smaller screen on it, because, you know, it's Platinum. Basically, it's to basically show that it's a re-release, so that's why it's a silver case, because it's Platinum. But, yeah, Ace Lightning, apparently I didn't own it. Wasn't Ace Lightning a freaking cartoon? I swear Ace Lightning was a cartoon back in the day. Like a really shitty 3D animated freaking cartoon. I can't remember. But yeah, pretty cool beans. Picked it up, why not? And I had a little argument. And then I found this at the car boot sale. Car boot sale. Can't go wrong. The guy bought it for a pound. I bought it for a pound off him, so works out pretty nicely. Crash Nitro Kart. Can't go wrong with that. Absolutely adore the Crash Nitro Kart series. I really do hope with the Crash Bandicoot Insanity Edition coming out on PlayStation 4 and assumedly Xbox One. I love how the Kinect case is broken on my desk. But yeah, I'm really hoping they revisit Crash Team Racing after that, if that sells well. So if you're a big fan of Crash Bandicoot, pick up a copy of Insanity, please, if it's good. So yeah, Crash Nitro Kart, can't go wrong. It's obviously a kart racing game. Can't go wrong with it. It's Crash Bandicoot, win. Comes complete with the manual and the disc. So boom. And that's all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. Fail. But yeah, basically, not very big pickings. Not very big pickings, although this wasn't a fast-forward run-through of the game pickups. Like, usually I'll do a flash-forward one, and I'll be like, try and get through them all, show you games. But it's been a while since I've done game pickups video. It's been a month since we last did one, and even then, I don't think I made that live. So, we're a Game & Pickles video behind. We're two Game & Pickles behind now, so I don't know if this one's going to get shown anytime soon. I really don't. But, it'll happen when it happens. I'm going to try and sort it all out. But yeah, we don't have many Game & Pickles this time. We're trying to cut down on them. We're basically trying to make some money now instead of spending it, because it's time for us to find a new place. That's what me and the girlfriend are working towards. It's going to take like a year or two. It's going to be a long-ass time. But hey, we need to start hunkering down, saving up those pennies. And I think, you know, we'll still look for games, but only ones that are probably worth getting. And not like filler games, like fucking Ace Lightning. But yeah, we'll try and find the good games. We'll still buy those, but other than that, we're pretty much saving up now. I'm gonna go for it. The next big purchase we're making is the PlayStation 4, the PlayStation VR, and Star Trek Bridge Crew and all that. We'll definitely be getting that. But other than that, I reckon Game Pickups is almost dead. It will be a very, very, very small series in the future, probably. I've basically called Game & Pickups dead about 4 times in the last couple of years. But they've always been alluding to this, to me saving up money. And every time I still end up buying a shit ton of games, and I just need to put my foot down now. So, sad times, but hey, the game collection is getting played now. For those of you who haven't been checking out my live stream while I've been doing it, we are finally playing the backlog. The backlog. The entirety of the backlog. All of it. You see all these games? You see all these games? All of them. They will all be played. This wall of games will finally be played. It is time. It is time. And we will play it. And we will maybe not complete the games, but we'll definitely check them out. We'll find out if they're any good. And then, I suppose, we'll let you know. As you can see, I've completely run out of shelving space. I'm actually piling games up now. That's how bad it is. That's how bad my collection is and how big my backlog is. It's ridiculous. So we need to cut down, save up that monies. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. And I'll see you guys next time. Take care. The girlfriend's not here to say it. Shit. What do we do? The girlfriend's not here to say it. Cut!